When evening's purple shadows turn to gloom and darkness, dread, superstition, and fear of the unknown linger. Underneath the shadows of a conscious world, in a deserted corner of your mind, sits an abandoned theater with only one seat. Please, come in. We've been expecting you. The show's about to begin. Open the eyes of your imagination and focus on the flickering screen of your own reality. There. See it? It's our latest episode of the Night Shift Theater, presented by the Sioux Empire Community Theater. As we researched the Italian-American experience, we stumbled onto a stunning, little-known radio program which seems to mirror a much more widely known television series entitled The Sopranos. And never being ones to shy away from cheap ripoffs, tonight we proudly present an episode of the soon-to-be-litigious program, The Pepperoni.
There you go, Tony. That rat fink, Louis Loose Lips Luigi, won't be doing any more talking to the feds.
Yeah. Too bad Louis Loose Lips wasn't the one talking to the feds.
He wasn't.
Nah, it was his cousin Lenny. Lousy oral hygiene Laconi. He's the guy we should have whacked.
Well, these things happen. What should we do with Louis's body?
Drop it in that ditch where we dumped Mario Missing Ear, Frank Fungus Toe, and Nikki No Name.
That's getting to be a crowded ditch.
You talking back to me, you lazy SOB?
No, Tony, never, Tony.
Okay, then. Listen, I gotta go.
Well, where are you running off to in such a hurry? We still got business.
Listen, I don't...
We gotta deal with those nuns that didn't cough up their insurance money. We gotta make the FOP donation, and we gotta unload those 58 crates of prophylactics we stole.
You can't...
Personally, I don't think that was such a good idea in the first place, Tony. I mean, 2 crates of prophylactics? I can see. But 58? That's a lot of boingy boingies to unload. You know what I'm saying?
Bruno.
Hey, maybe if we sold them as balloons at kids' birthday parties.
Bruno.
I mean, that Chuck E. Cheese guy might...
Bruno!
What?
You're the deputy of the association. You take care of it.
Where are you going in such a hurry? What's more important than the association?
Nothing. I got some other business, okay? Do you frickin' mind?
Sure thing, Tony. Sure thing.
Tony Pepperoni. How you doing, man?
Cut it, Petey. You think I want everybody knowing I'm here?
But it's your pizza parlor, Tony. You own it. You run it. You the man.
And what happens if anybody finds that out? Far as the world knows, I'm a nice, respectable mob boss. What happens to that reputation if word gets out I'm actually running a pizza parlor on the side?
It's a nice pizza parlor, Tony.
It's still pizza, Petey. You call it what you want. It's still tomato sauce, dough, cheese, and toppings. And God help me, I love it. I got pizza sauce in my blood. It's the only thing I'm really good at.
Yeah, perfectly fine mob boss too, Tony.
Don't try to frickin' placate me, okay, Petey? Don't you have some calzones to stuff?
Actually, that's what we need to talk about. We gotta make a decision on whether we go with a thick Chicago deep dish style or the crispy crust. Or both.
We gotta decide today?
New menus go to the printer next week.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
And actually, we got worse news.
Worse? You're busting my strombolis here.
There's a new pizza joint going in down the street.
In our territory?
On our block.
Is it that Cap'n Tony? Because if it is, they're going to find more than sausage in their meat lovers combo.
It's worse.
Worse?
It's Domino's.
No! Dear God, tell me you're yanking me.
Swear to God, Tony. Saw the blue and red logo in the window this morning myself.
Oh, God. Oh, God!
Tony, what's with the pills? You okay?
My doc prescribed them. To handle the stress. I can take 15 an hour. Domino's. Mother of Mary, Domino's. Those guys are gonna crush us like frickin' bugs. I thought the FBI was bad, but Domino's? They got those cheese sticks now. They got cinnamon sticks with icing. It's over. We're toast. Close the frickin' doors! Blow out the pilot light, Gracie! We're history!
How long does it take for those stress pills to kick in?
I have no frickin' idea, moron! I can't breathe! I gotta get out of here! I gotta see my wife and kids!
Are you gonna tell them about our pizza parlor?
What, do you think I'm insane? And lose what little respect they still got for me? Out of my way!
He never said deep dish or thin and crispy.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Mafia.
Can it, Carmella? I got a lot on my plate today.
Oh, not just on your plate. You got stains on your shirt, too. What is that?
Nothing. Just a stain.
Is that pizza sauce, Tony? You been hanging around a pizza joint?
No, it's just blood. Probably left over from Louie Loose Lips. We had to whack him today.
Are you sure it's not pizza sauce?
Look, a man's shirt is his business. Stains and all, capiche?
What about his family life? Is that his business too, huh?
Carmella.
The beauty shop is still charging me $40 for the tint and style, plus $60 for the nails and pedicure. And I told them if they didn't back down on the fee, that all the papers in town would be receiving compromising photos of Darius the head beautician in his blow dryer. And they laughed in my face. Now, I want to know where those photos are.
I don't got them yet. Donnie developing fluid Draco still hasn't come through yet.
Well, can you at least arrange a little accident with the conditioner?
No.
And you call yourself a mob boss.
Hey, Pops.
AJ, my boy, how you doing? Come give your old man a hug.
Nah, that's okay, Pops. I gotta run.
No time for your own father?
Actually, there is one thing I wanted to ask you.
Shoot. I meant it figuratively, you little dip.
Oh.
AJ, you're not holding the gun right anyway. Now keep your grip here with this finger resting on the trigger. And keep your target half an inch above the sight line, you know, like this.
Thanks, Ma.
Will you put that thing away?
Well, what I wanted to ask you was, today at school in the lunch line, Todd Wilkerson cut in front of me to get a chocolate milk.
Yeah?
It was the last chocolate milk.
Yeah?
So, can you whack him?
What?
Oh, please. Your father can't even extort a Ponzi hairdresser. What makes you think he's got the gorgonzolas to off out Todd Wilkerson?
Will you butt out?
Paging Don Corleone. Paging Don Corleone.
So you'll let this kid disrespect me in front of the whole school and everybody?
It was milk.
Chocolate milk.
The last chocolate milk.
Where are my pills?
Oh, hi, Dad.
Meadows. Thank God. I need someone who talks sense in this house.
I wanted to talk to you too, Dad.
Give me a hug.
That's okay. Listen, I got my grades back from college.
Yeah.
And in my Threats and Graphs 101 class, the teacher totally gave me a C+ on our money laundering for fun and profit exam.
Yeah?
So can you whack him?
No!
You might as well ask him to put a horse's head in your professor's bed. Not all, Mr. Queasy Weezy.
Well, what's the point of being a mob boss if you can't even change your daughter's GPA?
Is that the only thing this family can think about? Mob, mob, mob. There's more to life than the association, you know?
Children, go upstairs.
What's Dad talking about, Mom?
I can't believe you'd say such a thing in front of your own offspring.
Where's my stress pills?
Benny, no cuticles, bananas. Dad never acts like this.
I hate my life!
Me too!
You see what you do to this family? You think Paulie can't find the remote control Romano pulls this sort of crap? How many pills is that?
Doc says I can take 30 an hour. I gotta see my shrink.
Children, sit down. Sit down. We got work to do. We'll have some dinner, and then we still gotta figure out what to do with these 58 crates of prophylactics Bruno unloaded on us.
Thank you. So, what seems to be the problem this week, Mr. Pepperoni?
It's like I'm being torn in two. Like I'm a piece of chicken that's left over after it's eaten, and that has two parts. Where half the people I know got one part, and the other half got the other part, and they both pull to make a wish, and I snap. I'm like that, you know?
You feel like a wishbone.
A wishbone? Yeah! That's exactly what I feel like. It's like I'm a sponge-like thingy that just fills up and fills up and fills up, and then I'm pressed against the window to clean it, and all the stuff just comes pouring out.
You feel like a squeegee?
A squeegee! Exactly! I'm like a guy with two brains in one head. Like that mutant calf I saw in a museum one time. Only both my brains are about to explode out of my freaking ears.
You feel like a mob boss who secretly runs a pizza parlor?
No, not like that at all.
You feel like a squeegee?
Yes.
It seems to me the problem is your unconscious self using every method of denial and sublimation to hold together two diametrically opposed facets of your pre-verbal personality, but your stunted inner life is no match for your increasingly intolerable external realities.
I'm like a squeegee.
You're like a squeegee. Why not just give up on the pizza business? Just walk away. What?
You don't walk away from the pizza business. You go out face first in a mountain of mozzarella and grease. Or your sleeve gets caught on the pie pan and you're dragged into a 400 degree to bake like a ziti. Or you're speeding to deliver some pies downtown and broadside a livestock truck and you're crushed beneath the weight of thousands of pounds of cattle and poultry. That's the way a pizza man dies. There are 100 ways to go, but no one ever, ever walks away from pizza.
I see.
Walk away.
Then I have a question for you, Mr. Pepperoni.
Shoot.
I don't have a firearm, Mr. Pepperoni.
It's a frickin' figure of frickin' speech.
No need to shout, Mr. Pepperoni. I've been talking to my own psychiatrist about trying to counsel a man such as yourself.
Yeah, and I'm a handful, ain't I?
And he keeps telling me my problems aren't really with you, but with my own father.
Yeah?
So, I was thinking...
What?
Could you whack my father?
What?
Or at least my psychiatrist. He's driving me up the frickin' wall.
No! What is it with you people?
Then I think this session is over.
I just got here!
Here are 400 more stress pills, Mr. Pepperoni. Go nuts.
Welcome back to the pizza parlor.
Thanks, Petey.
You don't look so good. Can I get you something? Lasagna? Linguine? Mugu gaipan?
What?
I'm kidding. Here, have a slice of onion and anchovy. Mangia, mangia.
I ain't hungry.
Some vino? It's from the old country. Out in Ashtabula.
No. No wine.
Okay. But as long as I got you here, I gotta ask you something.
I'm not whacking anybody.
Okay, that's good to know. I was actually just wondering if we should order more of these red and white checkered tablecloths, or if we should go with something a little more hip. I can get these cute little lacy numbers, like doilies, paper doilies, you know, but bigger.
I don't care.
Also, people are beginning to suspect.
Suspect what?
That all these autographed photos on the walls may not be legit. Like they want a Frank Sinatra that says, "To Petey and the gang, best pizza in town."
Well, what's wrong with it?
Well, you probably shouldn't have signed it in crayon. Looks fishy, you know? And it's dated 2000. Old Blue Eyes bought it in 98. You know, little tip-offs like that.
So take down the pictures. Reforge them. I don't care.
And the name of the restaurant, Tony.
What's wrong with our name?
I know you don't want to have any connections between this place and your Italian heritage, like you're ashamed of us.
I'm not ashamed.
It's okay if we're something you sweep under your rug.
You're not under my rug.
You want to be a closeted pizza man? That's...
I'm not closeted.
Okay, fine. But the name. especially since Domino's is moving in.
Where's my pills? Where's my pills?
I think we need a little more Italian name for a restaurant.
What's wrong with the name we got?
Saul Herskowitz's Kosher Deli? Just don't say pizza, Tony.
I gotta cover my trail.
You're covering it too well.
I need more pills. I gotta calm down. And will someone shut that accordion player up before I whack him?
Sorry!
Oh, sure. You'll whack Joe Squeezebox Mancotti, but you won't whack that kid who took your son's chocolate milk?
He told you about that?
He stopped in earlier. Don't worry, I didn't tell him nothing.
I gotta get home. I gotta lie down.
So, you never answered me about the crusts.
I don't care.
And for a name, I was thinking of a compromise. Saul, the Sicilian Herskowitz's Kosher Pizzeria. How's that sound?
Wow, welcome home, Mr. Wussy Man.
I don't... What's with all the balloons?
Uncle Bruno brought them by. 58 crates full. So I blew them up and decorated the house.
Those aren't... balloons?
Can't you enjoy any freaking nice thing we do for you, you pig?
I don't got any patience for your lip right now, Carmella.
Fine. You don't want to hear my apology? You won't hear my apology.
You was gonna apologize?
Listen, honey. Me and the kids, we was all thinking you're out busting your rigatoni 24/7 to put food on our table and a roof over our heads.
And a 60-inch plasma HD TV in every room, including the garage.
Yeah.
And we realized that extortion, murder, and ruining people's lives was your day job. So how could we ask you to do it in your family time, too?
Yeah.
We love you for who you are, Pops. Not what you do for us.
You do?
So, we're gonna forget the scumbags at the beauty salon, and the dirt wipe who cut AJ off, and that piece of filth professor that screwed Meadows over.
Okay.
And just have a nice meal. Just the four of us.
And your Uncle Junior, and Silvio Lugnuts, and Aunt Stiletto, and Richie Paper or Plastic, and the rest of the family.
That sounds great. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, we already ordered in supper, see?
Is that...
Pizza!
Oh, my God.
Do you like it? It's from that new Domino's down the street.
You okay, Dad?
Oh, he looks kind of purple.
AJ, go call an ambulance. I think your father just suffered a heart attack.
Can we eat the pizza first while it's still warm?
Well, I don't see why not. Just step over your father there and cut some pieces for Uncle Junior and Cousin Toupee. Big slices. Don't be stingy.
Thank you for joining us in tonight's Night Shift Theater presentation, brought to you by the Sioux Empire Community Theater. Until we meet again, be careful. Be very careful.
This Sioux Empire Community Theater presentation of the Pepperonis featured Dave Baumeister as Bruno, Raine Jerke as Tony, Tamra Huffman as Carmella, Noah Kutter as AJ, Macie Lupica as Meadows, Amy Morrison as Dr. Melphi, and Petey and the Announcer by Jeff Gould. Voice editing and sound design by Jesse Jensen. The Pepperonis was written by Eric Coble and directed by Jeff Gould.